the Los Angeles Convention Center, where the world's automakers gather once a year to reveal their latest wares to literally thousands of attending press. It's the LA Auto Show, and over the next hour, join us as we take you behind the scenes during the show's press preview to see the latest new cars, trucks, concepts, and technologies being debuted here. So whether you're serious about cars or curious what will be rolling down tomorrow's roads, sit back, buckle up, and hang on as Fox Sports takes you on a ride around the LA Auto Show like you've never seen. The LA Auto Show, presented by Fox Sports. Welcome to the LA Auto Show. Hello, everybody. I'm Tor Dietrich. Well, all the automakers are here to show their latest creations to the world's largest automotive market, Southern California. And with 50 new car debuts, LA is the first big stop this auto show season. And we have our Fox Sports Auto Show team here, Nick Miles and Mike Caudill, to show you all the new metal and give you some perspective. And joining me now, Jack Nerad, editorial director for Kelley Blue Book, and good friend. Jack, we have a new administration coming in. There's talk of tax relief. This is good news for automakers, right?
It could be very, very good news. We might be prone for a big, big economic expansion in 2017. At the same time, there's a lot of speculation that we'll have a down year.
Now, what about CUVs? I'm seeing them all over the place here.
CUVs are going through the roof. We're talking about tall vehicles, crossover vehicles. Once you're in a tall vehicle, you never want to get in a sedan again. We're seeing a major galactic shift in what's going on in vehicles.
Thanks, Jack. And we'll have more from Jack later in the show. But now it's time to turn our attention to sports cars. Mike?
Tor, well, it's great to be in LA, and I know you asked for a sports car. I'm not giving it to you yet. I'm going to show you this right here. We're in the Divergent 3D booth here at the LA Auto Show, and this motorcycle was developed using 3D software. They made this from the ground up. Really cool, but I know you want to get to what's newsworthy here in the booth. Of course, as we make our way down the row in the Divergent booth, I'm going to showcase a few of these products that were made using 3D software. This is actually the exposed chassis of the sports car we're going to see here in a minute. And as you look at this vehicle, you can see that they went for the aerodynamic, lightweight construction with carbon fiber and aluminum. All right, I know you want to get to the sports car. Let's go take a look at it. It's called the Divergent 3D Blade. And although a lot of the techno fiends in the market have seen this vehicle out already, this is the first automotive appearance for this vehicle. And I was talking to their engineering team yesterday. They did one thing really special with this vehicle during the development phase. They made each one of these pieces removable. So if you wanted to make the tires and wheels wider for more track-based performance, you can actually do that. I had a chance earlier today to speak with their president and CEO. This is what his thoughts were on this car.
With 3D metal printing, these vehicles are so customizable that we're looking for someone to understand the technology and participate in adapting and evolving this car to their tastes and interests over their total ownership of the car.
Over here in BMW, oh, the lap of luxury. And although I'd love to be driven around New York City by a chauffeur, this vehicle right here, it's not about the life of luxury. Yeah, it is, but this is all about performance and basing this vehicle on the track. This is the BMW M760. What does that mean? That M stands for motorsport. Carbon core exterior, 6.6 liter V12 pushing out 600 horsepower. But if you just look at the exterior of this vehicle, BMW has done it right. It's got air vents up on the front that allow those brakes to cool and big aggressive wheels. There's nothing about this vehicle that doesn't scream track performance. The M760 is both well equipped on the interior with luxurious features and packed with performance both on the exterior and under the hood. Starting price is about $153,000, and we hope to see this vehicle on the road very soon.
They introduced their first civilian vehicle to America in 1945. They're known as America's Rugged Outdoor Company, and they chose LA to add a new member of the family, the Compass.
Jeep steps it up a notch with a new Compass. It's a world vehicle, and because of that, it'll be made in different factories all over the world, serving different markets. Solid good looks are the foundation for the new Compass, taking its lines from the Grand Cherokee, chiseled and rugged. On initial impressions, it is well proportioned with clean lines and a well-balanced design. On the inside, more premium features that we haven't seen in the past. Soft touch materials and well thought out technology. A full touch screen with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. Stepping it up for the outdoor enthusiasts, the Trailhawk version is pure durability. What separates it from the huge fleet of SUVs available from other automakers today is that it's a real Jeep with true off-road capabilities, and it has a standout handsome look, not seen in many of the run-of-the-mill SUVs. The premium version is full of luxury items, and that resonates well with showgoers. The Compass is one of Jeep's best-selling SUVs to date, so why change it?
It's always about moving forward, looking forward, so the technology, the safety, the connectivity that consumers expect today in today's vehicles, that's where the new Compass is going to come in.
For those that want the authentic Jeep experience, it'll be coming to the US in a 4x4 manual and a 4x2 manual, as well as an automatic transmission. Kia gives a big boost to its CUV, the 2017 Soul. The top trim level, the Exclaim, gets a turbocharger on the engine to boost the power up to 201 horsepower. And just to let people know, they have added some exterior trim pieces. Until now, the Plus trim level only made 161 horsepower out of the 2-liter engine. The new engine gets a 7-speed dual-clutch transmission, and we're told its combined fuel economy will be 28 miles a gallon. That's better than the 2 lower horsepower engines that the vehicle comes with now. More power, better fuel economy, and 18-inch wheels. Red exterior stripes and chrome around the grille make the 2017 Soul Exclaim stand out. On the safety side, it'll come with cross-traffic alert and blind spot detection. Some nice upgrades for 2017.
Now, if your old Soul wasn't fast enough, now you have the turbo. My favorite part is those twin-tipped chrome exhausts at the back.
Coming up, BMW is expanding its electrics. Plus, we take a look at compact SUVs, cool concepts, and of course, fast new sports cars. It's all coming to you as Fox Sports presents the LA Auto Show.
The LA Auto Show on Fox Sports.
And welcome back. Well, we just saw the awesome performance of the M760, but BMW is charging up their electrics. Using technology from the i3 and the i8, BMW is showing us the 330e, the X5e, and the new 740e. Yes, we're talking about the magnificent 7 Series. It now has an electric option, blending a highly efficient twin-turbo four-cylinder gas engine that, together with its electric motor, outputs some 322 horsepower, giving the 740e a 0-60 in just a click over 5 seconds. Now, the 7 is known for its autonomous features, most notably active driving assistant that nearly drives the car itself. Actually, the new 7 can park itself even if you're not in the car, which isn't allowed just yet in the US. And what can I tell you about the inside of a 7 that you don't already know? It is a lap of luxury with a commanding cockpit that today boasts some very cool technology, like BMW's gesture control that lets you change the radio volume by swiping your hand. The 740e has eye performance with intelligent all-wheel drive, up to 87 miles per hour on electric alone, with a 14-mile range. In fact, the EPA has awarded the 740e with a whopping 64 MPGE rating. Now, if all that performance and technology isn't enough for you, you can even select the aroma within the car. That's the new BMW 740e.
Italian bands are big, hot, and sexy right now, and definitely making big waves in the United States. Alfa Romeo just introduced a new sedan called the Giulia, and on the heels of that, at the LA show, introduced a brand new SUV, and we're going to find all about it from Reid Bigland. Reid, you are the CEO of Alfa Romeo. What's all the fuss about?
Well, all the fuss is about the new Alfa Romeo Stelvio midsize SUV behind us. 505 horsepower engine, 0 to 60 in 3.9 seconds. And obviously the trend towards SUVs in this country, the timing couldn't be better for really a no-compromise SUV. It performs like a two-seater sports car from a driving dynamics and performance perspective. but all of the functionality that people would expect and want in a sport utility vehicle. And we're pretty confident that this will be the fastest SUV in the world.
Now, a lot happened at Alfa Romeo over the last 24, 36 months. What does the next 24, 36 months look like?
Hey, we're living in the now, but we're committed to bringing Alfa Romeo back to its position around the world as a true premium brand, offering incredible performance, of course, gorgeous Italian design and style, and state-of-the-art technology.
Reed, thanks very much. I, by the way, have driven the Giulia. Outstanding vehicle. I'm saving my pennies in that penny jar to get myself one. Now, here are some other SUVs we've been looking at the show.
Over at the Land Rover booth, big news in the arrival of the Land Rover Discovery. This is the fifth generation of this SUV for the Land Rover. Sleek headlights and grille, clamshell hood, and trademark stepped roof are all in place. The C-pillar at the back is quite different since it slopes forward, and the tailgate is a one-piece instead of the traditional two-piece. This third-row SUV overcomes the complexity of seat configuration by making the seats electric, and they fold down by the touch of a button. Under the hood, a four-cylinder engine and a six-cylinder engine, along with a diesel engine. Inside, a very elegant cabin with a 10-inch screen and a Terrain Response 2 system with an auto mode, so the vehicle can respond automatically if you need it to do some off-roading. For those that are not competent with backing up with a trailer, there is a semi-autonomous trailer backup.
And for someone like me who has a hard time finding a parking space, this is the perfect car to pick up the dogs from daycare. Over to you.
Mini is launching the all-new Countryman here at the LA Auto Show, and there are three different versions, starting with this right here. This is actually the Mini Countryman, and this is the Cooper. This is all-wheel drive vehicle. I love the look. Mini is no longer small. Mini is actually large. It'll compete in the small compact SUV segment. If you want to step it up from the Cooper, you can go with the Cooper S. 189 horsepower. This thing is a pocket rocket. Fast, but more importantly, it's about the interior that makes this vehicle special. They want to compete with the Toyota RAV4. Interior cargo capacity, about the same, but that leather on the interior is something that sets it apart. So come over here. This is all about making the Countryman economical for the family and also paying attention to the environment, the best of both worlds. All-wheel drive, creature comforts, but guess what? Plug it into the wall, charge your vehicle, and away you go. So they have three models they're showcasing here at the LA Auto Show. And earlier today, I had a chance to speak with one of their representatives about this Countryman right here.
We're very excited about this silver car in the back, a plug-in hybrid version of the Countryman. It's our first plug-in hybrid ever. We're looking at range that is comparable to our cousins in the BMW group with their plug-in hybrid models. For a lot of people, it will cover their commute. And if you've run out of energy from the battery, you drive it like a normal car.
Nissan is announcing their largest ever vehicle to date. It's actually this right here. It's the 3035 Nissan TIE Fighter, and they're making it out of intergalactic sheet metal, and it's powered by a lithium-ion motor. Unfortunately, I'm not going to be alive to own one of these, but a vehicle that you can own is actually this vehicle right here. This is the all-new Nissan Star Wars Rogue One Special Edition vehicle. And what makes it special is they partnered with Star Wars to put a variety of different accents on here to pay tribute to the new movie that's going to be coming out. So they're tying in that white and black theme that's so well associated with those movies. And the best part about it, and I know I'm showing all the accents on this, but here's the best part about it. If you are a Star Wars aficionado, you get a helmet. They're going to send you a Stormtrooper helmet if you buy this vehicle.
What we have done is partnered with the film, and we have released the Rogue One Star Wars Limited Edition Rogue. We have 5,400 that have been specially trimmed out. Blacked out front end, limited edition Star Wars. It comes with a commemorative Death Trooper helmet. Here's a chance to get a great car that's a unique treatment, and it happens to have a tie-in to one of the greatest films in history.
Obviously, we're excited about the all-new Star Wars Rogue One, and of course, you get a helmet with it, and as I noted, there are 5,400 of these that they're going to make, but I hate to tell you, they just went down one, because guess what? I'm taking off with it.
Ford introduces the EcoSport here in LA. It's their smallest utility vehicle yet, as the automaker tries to grab a piece of the fastest-growing CUV segment. For Ford, it's all about space-saving convenience and SUV capability. All-wheel drive is standard. Seating 5, the inside is highlighted by a big 8-inch floating screen with CarPlay and Android Auto connectivity. The EcoSport also features fast-charging USB ports and a 110-volt plug if you need it. There are 30 bins and storage spaces in the EcoSport, including pockets for rear seat passengers to hold their cell phones. And using FordPass, you can start, lock, unlock, or locate your vehicle from just about anywhere. Look for the Ford EcoSport in dealerships in 2018. Next up, we find some small cars with big attitude. We show you the latest in tech with connected cars, and we show you some new trucks ready to haul as Fox Sports presents the LA Auto Show. And welcome back. Now, Nissan has a new version of its funky Juke. This is called the Juke Black Pearl, and it offers a new level of customization for buyers. Just check out the white pearl accents around the car. Inside, some fun with the trim. Nissan believes the Juke has a special audience for its extrovert design. And a little history. The color comes from the 1978 280Z Black Pearl. Now, if you like it, you better act fast. There's only 1,250 units to be sold.
Thanks, Tor. I know you wanted your black and white Star Wars theme with this Fiat 124 Spider right here, but I've got a showstopper for you here at the LA Auto Show. Come over here. You got to check this out. This is one of the hottest vehicles here at the show, and it's the 2017 Jeep Trailcat. This thing is bad to the bone, guys. Meant for the off-road with 40-inch PFG tires on it, a worn winch on front, 5-point harness. This thing is ready to hit the trails with Dana 60 axles to make sure you've got enough power on the dirt to really move this thing up and down mountainsides. But it's under here, it's under the hood that what really counts. It's got 700 horsepower and it's built with the Hellcat engine. This thing, it's a machine, bad to the bone.
They're fully road legal, trail capable. We'll have them in town driving around or on a trail. People stop and talk to you, and we get good conversations going with those. It is a driver, but it's in a concept sort of a form. The whole idea of that vehicle was, can we get together with a Hellcat 700 horsepower Hemi and a Jeep Wrangler? Does that work together? Yeah.
What I liked about the Jeep was the fact that it had off-road attitude. But if you're looking for a vehicle that actually has track-based and street attitude, this might be the vehicle for you right here. Let me get out of the way. I want to show it to you. It's the all-new Nissan Nismo Sentra. And here's what makes this vehicle a showstopper for a millennial in the marketplace. It's very expensive to put aftermarket products on a vehicle, but Nissan, yeah, they say, what the heck, we'll give it to you. More aggressive wheels and tires help you stick to the track. A nice aerodynamic package on here that keeps you low and hugging to the ground. Also a spoiler on the rear of this vehicle as well. Now the Nismo name is associated, of course, with their motorsports and performance brand. Take a look on the inside here. The Sentra has never worn that Nismo name, and they're putting all the motorsport eccentric stuff on the inside, like seats that hug your body. Now, here's what I can tell you. Pricing has not been announced, but I know it's gonna be sub $25,000. So for the entry-level enthusiast in the marketplace, this is gonna be the vehicle for you. It goes on sale early next year, and I'm looking forward to seeing this vehicle on the street.
From ride sharing to cars that can converse with you, from all that autonomous cars to cars that can fly, and then there's all that car security. You'll find it at the Automobility Tent outside the LA International Auto Show.
It's a gathering of all the latest tech and the future of transportation in our industry. As car communication grows, so do automotive cybersecurity companies. Every time you communicate with your vehicle, like clicking the key fob or via your cell phone, automotive companies are working hard to prevent hackers getting access to your personal data. There are plenty of other transportation ideas around the show.
Now, once you get too tired to move around the LA International Auto Show, you can use something like this Honda Unicub. It's the latest in mobility, and you don't have to walk anywhere.
There were conferences on flying cars and whether they may be a reality one day, and some new ideas from car sharing. BMW launched their new Reach Now program, a very modern way of sharing cars using your cell phone.
You sign up for free by downloading our app for iPhone or Android. We scan your credit card, we scan your driver's license, and we take a selfie. We validate your identity, and then you're signed up and good to go. When you use your phone to find and unlock a car, we charge you 41 cents a minute, and it really allows you to take a car from anywhere in the city, move around, go outside the city, go for trips.
At Automobility, Hyundai became the first mainstream automaker to connect cars with homes using Amazon Echo and its new BlueLink skill for Amazon Alexa. Starting immediately, Hyundai owners will have the convenience of locking and unlocking and remote starting their vehicles from the comfort of their couch, kitchen, or bedroom using voice commands. The new BlueLink skill from Amazon Alexa is available across Alexa-enabled devices and Hyundai vehicles equipped with second generation of BlueLink. Owners of the new Hyundai Ioniq electric and plug-in electric vehicles are able to start and stop charging of their cars with the ease of simple voice commands with the BlueLink skill. Hyundai owners can request various functions from their vehicle, including remote stop and start charging, remote engine start with climate control, remote door locking and unlocking, and remote horn and light access across all enabled Hyundai models.
Finally, with Echo, I'll start to have something or someone in my personal life that'll start listening to me.
After the break, we show you the latest concepts, including Jaguar's iPace, the best ways to haul your family, and an SUV for those demanding luxury and performance, as Fox Sports presents The LA Auto Show.
You're watching The LA Auto Show on Fox Sports.
And welcome back. Now behind me is Jaguar's F-Pace. Jaguar has been so successful with the F-Pace, they're expanding their CUV lineup. Starting with this, the I-Pace is Jaguar's first all-electric vehicle. The hood cutout and front-end design actually provides cooling for the battery compartment and also helps with aerodynamics. Packaging an all-electric car does have its advantages. While the F-Pace is longer in length than the I-Pace has more interior volume. The seats are thinner again for more space. Check out the legroom. It's endless. Jaguar is also showing you their multi-screen future, which they believe will be gesture and touch oriented, eliminating many knobs and buttons. The I-Pace is powered by two electric motors, one for each axle with an estimated 220-mile range from its 90 kilowatt-hour battery. 0 to 60, about 4 seconds. What's more, Jaguar says the I-Pace high-voltage charger will fully charge in just 2 hours. And Jaguar plans to go to production with the I-Pace in 2018. In fact, Jaguar says that a full 50% of their cars will be electric or partial electric by 2020.
Everybody loves a concept car. The ideas of what could be fascinate showgoers and attracted big crowds at this year's LA Auto Show.
Mitsubishi have become known for some of the best concept cars to be seen at auto shows. This year, they took the opportunity to show off the new futuristic and racy-looking EX Concept Compact SUV. The remarkable news is that the vehicle will be a long-range EV, the next generation of electrified vehicles from Mitsubishi.
Strong hint at a design future for the brand. It's 100% electric and compact. Range is always an issue. So cruising on this vehicle, 248.5 miles.
This is an aerodynamic looking electric crossover type vehicle. It is sporty with flowing lines, a low slung roof, a shooting brake style liftgate, blacked out windows, and oversized wheels. Even though this is a concept, it has the distinctive look of a Mitsubishi. The front end has the Mitsubishi Dynamic Shield interpretation, portrayed by the company's design direction. The future of Mitsubishi is with crossovers and electrification, according to a company insider. It has a twin motor all-wheel drive system, putting out a combined 188 horsepower. The EX will have advanced autonomous driving features using cameras and sensors, and have three driving modes for gravel, snow, or rain. On top of that, the concept can work as a power source. If your electricity at home goes out, the vehicle can power up your dwelling for a number of days. Another showstopper concept was revealed by Subaru, the Visiv 7 SUV concept. This is big, a three-row seven-seater that carries forward the company's core concepts. Subaru say it'll have capability, safety, and dependability. It is designed ready for the outdoor adventurer and the weekend warrior. The new SUV is monstrous at 17 feet, which makes it longer than the Chevy Tahoe. A final rendition of the vehicle will be introduced to the North American market in early 2018.
This concept shows the size and direction that Subaru is headed with their largest third-row vehicle to date. Now check out this.
This is the Toyota CHR. Yeah, it's beautiful, right? Look at those aggressive wheels. Tennille, can we take a look at the front of this? All right, let's go look at the front of this thing. All right, here we go. So you can see this is an aggressive looking stance for the from the folks over at Toyota. And let me tell you what, this thing is an absolute showstopper. Looking for a great family hauler? All new and built from the ground up, this 2-liter 144 horsepower four-cylinder engine under the hood is a great family vehicle. What makes it great? Four USB charging stations. I know for me, I have kids at home, they are looking to power their iPads and all their electronic devices. And for moms with kids, the rear passenger doors open up 90 degrees for easy access. And not to mention, you need all those incredible safety features in the vehicle, like lane departure warning, adaptive cruise control, blind spot detection, and of course, 10 different airbags. All right, we had a chance to talk to a few of the engineers earlier today here in the Toyota booth at the LA Auto Show. This is what they had to say about the CHR.
Toyota wanted to go different, and they wanted to do something bold, new, and something that they've never done before. And that's what they did with the new Toyota CHR. A lot of families can have a lot of choices, so definitely the design is a big choice that they're gonna look for. They are going for millennials, but they're also going for anybody that wants something that's fun to drive, stylish, stands out, and makes them feel interesting and different, as well as the safety.
And we're sitting in the Acura's Precision cockpit. Now, here to tell us more about it is Matt Slister. Matt, tell us, what exactly is this? It's not a car.
So this is an interior design and technology direction for the future of the Acura brand. In Detroit this year, we revealed the Acura Precision concept, which is our exterior design direction, and it was extremely well received. But interiors and technology are really what set brands apart today for buyers. They want to connect their phone, they want a nice looking sleek interior and operating system, and that's what this delivers.
Okay, now the first thing you notice is one knob, right?
So this right here is a dynamic mode dial, and this adapts the suspension and the steering. It's adapted from the NSX, and this is really pointing towards a sporty direction for the brand.
Tell me what we can see with the two different screens.
The first thing you notice is the driver display. It's an ultra-wide 12-inch LCD, and what it showcases is a new driver's dial. As you can see here, there's a new semi-autonomous driver layout that positions the car in the road. It also shows other cars and pedestrians leveraging the vehicle's advanced sensors. And what this does is it builds human confidence in the car's semi-autonomous system.
And this screen?
This is a matching center display screen that houses all of your standard infotainment features, whether it's navigation or music. And what you notice about the design is that it's very clean, it's very simple, it's very visible, and it's directly in the driver's natural line of sight. So you can keep your eyes on the road with all of your main features right in the line of sight.
Well, there you have it, the Precision cockpit from Acura. Coming up, we show you the latest high mileage SUVs, high performance German roadsters, and great new ways to haul the family as Fox Sports presents the LA Auto Show.
On Fox Sports.
And welcome back. Now, one of the great things about an auto show is bringing the family. This is the new Mitsubishi Outlander. We found a kid inside to tell us what he likes. What's your favorite thing, Caleb?
My favorite thing about the 2017 Mitsubishi Outlander is probably going to be the multi-view camera. The camera's on the front, back, and sides of the car. And if I had eyes on the front, back, and sides of my head, I'd be a multi-view camera system for the Outlander.
Well, there you go. Now with more on family haulers, here's Mike.
This is my favorite segment because this keeps my kids quiet. Sometimes, as I tell my kids, it's better to read the writing on the wall. This is the all-new 7-passenger Volkswagen Atlas. This is a 2018 model year vehicle. This is my favorite feature on this vehicle. I'm going to call this a showstopper. This is for the moms at home watching. All right, you got the car seat in the back of your vehicle right here, and you get frustrated, right? You got to pull it out because you want to put somebody in the third row. No more, says Volkswagen. You simply flip this switch forward. It goes far enough to where you can keep your kid's car seat in here without having to take it out, and you can fit a full-size adult in the rear of this vehicle. There are 4 USB connectors. There's 2 in the front for the adult, and then, of course, the kids have 2 in the back, second row rear, and then, of course, it's a third row seated vehicle, and you have a 12-volt adapter as well. As we make our way around, I want to give you the rear look of this vehicle, just the boldness of the stance. I think this is true innovation, and you get a lot of cars to look at here at the auto show, but this 2018 Volkswagen Atlas, this one is the showstopper for me, guys.
Well, when we designed and developed this vehicle, we really had the American customer in mind, and it's usually a busy family, so it has all these elements from the size of the vehicle, the interior flexibility, to something simple like easy opening of the trunk.
Honda says, hold on, Volkswagen. They think they have the best family hauler, and it's this vehicle right here. It's the all-new 2017 Honda CR-V. Let me get in here and tell you a little bit more about it. It comes in a 4-cylinder option, but it's really that 1.5-liter turbo that makes this thing a standout. Now, let's talk about the family hauler aspect. This one has a door that opens 90 degrees, giving that occupant much easier access. So for the kids that want to slip into the vehicle, makes it a lot easier. All right, USB. We love to talk about powering inside your vehicle. There are 4 USB connective stations inside this vehicle. 2 in the front, 2 in the rear. As we make our way around the vehicle, Honda did a really good job at putting the design element into this all-new CR-V.
We wanted to take it a little bit further and give it a little bit more aggressive styling, give it a wider stance, a little lower, without alienating what made CR-V so popular in the past. But the interior, everywhere you look, is fine touch materials. We really wanted to take it up to give it a real luxury feel.
We're showing the family hauler aspect here at the LA Auto Show, and I can tell you, after the 2 vehicles that we just saw, this Honda CR-V is definitely one your kids are going to be interested in.
For some time now, the lines between premium CUVs and non-premium CUVs have become blurred, and Mazda continues that with the new CX-5.
When you have a top-selling, award-winning, top fuel economy vehicle, it's a huge risk to roll out a new version of it. But Mazda is moving forward with a new CX-5. We asked Mazda why change what is already a winner for them.
We see the competitive landscape changing. We've got a couple tricks up our sleeve, and we'll continue to push the envelope with efficiency. That's what Mazda's all about.
This 4-door, 5-passenger 2017 CX-5 will boast better handling, improved interior, a sportier look, and the sort of premium paint found on top European cars. The CX-5 is a big seller for Mazda, making up 25% of its sales worldwide. And the company sold 100,000 of them last year. So what has changed on this model? The 2017 Mazda CX-5 has sharpened exterior lines and a high-quality reworked interior. Mazda want to keep the CX-5 as an affordable crossover, but hope that the crossover shopper will consider the CX-5 when looking for a premium vehicle. Mazda did tell us it'll have a 2-liter and 2.5-liter engine, and will also come in a 2.2-liter diesel engine. Customers can expect to see it mid-2017 in showrooms. Mini used to be small cars, but not anymore. They are now a premium, smaller, fun-to-drive car and part of the BMW brand. The Clubman has the same interior space as Toyota's RAV4, but on the floor of the LA Auto Show, a very special Mini Clubman, the John Cooper Works Edition. This is the first Mini to combine the racing engineering from the John Cooper Works signature and the brand's new all-4 all-wheel drive system. Under the hood, a powerful turbocharged 2-liter that outputs an astonishing 228 horsepower wrapped in a lightweight shell. The 0 to 60 time is 6 seconds, and when you go fast, you need to stop fast, so Mini have slapped on some Brembo brakes. Putting the power on the road is the standard 6-speed manual, or you can step it up for the optional 8-speed automatic transmission. And the car tops out at 147 miles an hour. To personalize your Mini, you will find many extras available, but the John Cooper Works comes with a number of items you can't get on the regular Clubman, including aerodynamic body kit, enhanced engine and brake cooling, black 18-inch John Cooper Works grip spoke wheels, John Cooper Works performance sports seats with integrated headrest, the John Cooper Works sports suspension, and dual outlet chrome tip sports exhausts.
Now I have to tell you, I actually own a Mini Clubman and it is big enough to get all of my five dogs inside the car, but it doesn't come with the Union Jack socks.
Next up, if you're looking for true luxury in an SUV with sports car performance, we found the car of your dreams. Plus, the latest trucks and performance roadsters. It's all coming to you as Fox Sports presents the LA Auto Show.
You're watching the LA Auto Show on Fox Sports.
And welcome back. Now, if you're looking for the ultimate in luxury for your SUV, I think I found the answer. This is the 2017 Range Rover SV Autobiography Dynamic. And here to tell us more is Simon Turner from Land Rover. Simon, tell us about the exterior.
It has an appearance on the outside that just oozes performance. 550 horsepower engine, 502 foot-pounds of torque. And what we're actually doing here is just creating a more sporting and dynamically inclined Range Rover model.
For it to be an autobiography, you've done things different from your normal Range Rover. What's that?
Range Rovers are renowned for luxury, composure, refinement. This vehicle has all of that, but it has a greater level of dynamic responsiveness and performance on road.
But what about the sound system? It's very unique.
A couple of years ago, we partnered with a company called Meridian, and Meridian are renowned for making world-class audio systems. This particular one in the Range Rover is a 1700-watt 3D 29-speaker surround sound system. It just fills the cabin with really great sound.
But the as an SVA autobiography, this also is very custom.
There's some features, materials, and appointments on the inside of the car that make it unique. Chrome, knurled dials that really raise the level of luxuriousness and appointments inside the vehicle.
Okay, there you go. The 2017 Range Rover SV Autobiography Dynamic.
We're here in the Chevy booth right now, and I just want to walk you through quickly. You know, the truck market, it's growing so much right now. You got the Z71 right here. That's all packed with performance. And what's great about the truck industry is we're also talking about accessorizing our trucks as well. If you keep making your way through the booth here, this is a kind of a showstopper for me. This is a partnership actually with Hurley, the apparel company. Integrating a snorkel, putting your surfboards on top, finding ways to get in front of a new audience. The real showstopper, this one right here. This is the all new Chevy Colorado, and this is the ZR2. They want to go directly up head to head against Ford and their Raptor. How are they going to do it? That's right, specially tuned suspension makes a big difference. Front and rear locking differentials. So for the off-road enthusiast, rock crawling, trail running. I wanted to get a little bit more information on this vehicle about what makes that on-road and off-road balance what it is with this vehicle right here. Here's what the folks at Chevy had to tell me.
Well, Chevy's all about performance. And what the space was missing was an off-road capable midsize pickup truck that could do just about everything. It's capable off-road, but it doesn't mean you're gonna jar your teeth on-road. That is what sets this truck apart from the other competition.
All right, one of the trends here at the LA Auto Show is about taking a normal truck and turning it into something that is a little bit more off-road capable, but still comfortable on the street. So we saw the ZR2 over in the Chevy booth, but now we're over in the Ram booth. I'm gonna jump out of this vehicle here. It's the all-new 1500 Rebel Mojave Sand Edition. The color actually applies to the Mojave Desert here in California. Under the hood, a 5.7 liter motor popping out just under 400 horsepower, but it's really about providing comfort with a vehicle that can also go off-road. I love the color. More importantly, I love the functionality. Like back here, you have these nice little hatches that you can use to store things in. Not to mention, if you want to use it to double up as a cooler, you can do that as well. All right, you ready? I know I'm supposed to just cover this vehicle, but I want to cover this vehicle right here. And this is the 2017 Ram Rebel TRX Concept. This thing is meant for one thing and one thing only, and that's going hardcore off-road. 37-inch Toyo open country tires and specially tuned suspension with King off-road shocks. As we make our way down, I want you to peek inside this vehicle. Look at the special attention to detail with that TRX stitching and the red accents. Here's one unique feature as well. They mount the tires in the back, and that's for Baja off-road type racing. You want to have your spare tires available because when you lose a tire, you want to be able to quickly put one on. A lot of exciting news here in Ram with both the Mojave and this special edition concept right here.
Now, if you're looking for a sports car, you might want to look at luxury brand Audi. They have a brand new S5 at the show that comes in a sportsback and a coupe, and it also seats five.
Just for convenience, the car is available with two and five doors. The sportsback, A5 and S5, offer distinctive styling with excellent versatility. The new Audi sportsback is a functional and sporty choice for customers who want speed, style, technology, and luxury.
Someone who needs an A4, but wants the design of an A5, and you've combined them together, and you have the best of both worlds. We've added more power, we've sculpted it more, and you have more usability and versatility in the car.
Audi says the new models maintain generous cabin space while lowering and widening the vehicle's stance. All Audi 5 model vehicles share new and upgraded driver assistance programs. Under the hood in the A5 is a 2-liter, 4-cylinder Audi turbocharged gasoline engine, which makes 252 horsepower and 273 pounds-foot of torque. The S5 Sportsback will come with a new 3-liter turbocharged V6, also available in the two-door S5 model that makes 354 horsepower and 369 pounds-foot of torque. Both come standard with Audi's Quattro all-wheel drive system. Mercedes-Benz used the LA Auto Show to release its new masterpiece sports car for the open-air segment, the new AMG GTC Roadster. It has perfect sports car proportions, but it also offers outstanding driving dynamics. The GTC features a handcrafted 4-liter twin-turbo engine that is rated at 550 horsepower. That power is sent to the road from a 7-speed twin-clutch automatic transmission. Mercedes-Benz boasts it will have instantaneous shifts with a 0 to 60 mile an hour time of just 3.7 seconds. Now, what makes this a real sports car is a top speed of 188 miles an hour, 0 to 60 in 3.9 seconds, and a full suite of Mercedes-Benz safety systems.
And joining me once again, Jack Nierath from Kelley Blue Book. Jack, great show. Now I want to talk about the car behind us first, the Stelvio.
There wouldn't be a luxury market these days without luxury crossovers. Alfa Romeo has to establish itself as a luxury brand, and having a great crossover like this is going to go a long way to do that.
Jack, plenty of other CUVs as well. How about the Mazda CX-5?
Well, it's a terrific vehicle in the hottest segment in the marketplace. That's compact SUV. It's going to do very, very well.
Okay, another compact SUV, the Jeep Compass.
A lot of auto journalists like myself weren't in love with the previous Jeep Compass. This is a much better vehicle, and the previous one sold really well.
Land Rover Discovery.
Land Rover Discovery, and particularly the Discovery First Edition, it's a 3-row where adults can actually sit in the 3rd row. That's very, very important. It's going to add to their sales in the United States.
Okay, and technology. Hyundai is showing how you can use Alexa to start your car.
The tech companies want to be auto companies. The auto companies want to be tech companies. That's a nice melding of the two.
And Jack, BMW with their 7 Series, they have the new M760 and also a 4-cylinder 740E.
They're trying to cover all ends of the marketplace. They have iPerformance, they have M-Performance, they have the general BMWs on top of that, and the luxury consumer really wants differentiation, and that's what BMW is giving them.
Finally, let's talk about the I-Pace from Jaguar.
Well, I think it's going to be a major hit. It's a great-looking vehicle. Tall vehicles are so important now. People want to be up in the air. With the high technology of the I-Pace on top of that, it's going to be a winner in the market, I think.
Thanks, Jack. Well, it looks like that's all the time we have. For Nick Miles and Mike Caudill, I'm Tor Dietrich. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you on the road.